leaders are born, not made. Or leaders are made, not born. How many of you agree with this? Leaders are born and not made. The leadership skills that you possess is by your birth. How many of you believe that? I just want a hand like this. Yeah, it seems like we have more optimists. So having said that, how many of you have been an admin for a WhatsApp group? At least one WhatsApp group. All of us. So it's clear that like all of us are leaders, isn't it? At least we are leader of one group.
In that group, everybody is an admin.
Yeah, everybody is a leader. It doesn't mean that if you are an admin of 17 WhatsApp group that you're a leader, or it also doesn't mean that you have to be a senior vice president to be a leader. What exactly being a leader mean? What is the definition of a leader? So we will try to understand this. We have football fan here. So let's assume that I have read 52 books on how to play football. I know all the rules. I know all the rules about the football. I know how is it being played. I know the number of players. I know each and everything. And I've watched so many YouTube videos on how to play football. So do you think I can become a coach for an Indian football team?
No, you actually need an experience
for that. Right. He said you actually need an experience. So that means leader requires an experience. He should lead by example. All of you agree with it? Or is there anybody who says that that's okay, experience is not important? No, right? It needs an experience. So the second point, I have a question for all of you. So how many of you are managers here before that? Just, okay, none of us are managers, okay. So how many of you have team meetings at around 12:30 or 4:35? I think some of us, right? What do you think might be the reason for that?
So if there's lunch, the timeline, and there's a 5 o'clock gap, so yeah, you will finish it, you will wrap it up.
Yeah, that is one of the reason. And I think the other reason is that is the only reason employees don't argue much. They keep quiet. They accept what is being told. So if there is something about conveying or arguing, usually the meetings are kept in those slots. So you can observe that a leader is the one who requires from an experience to a smartness to suppress people. So he needs all the skills. So leader is not just a position where he can handle. It's a skill. It's a set of skills. He needs a variety of skills. So now we all of us are clear about who exactly is a leader and what are his skills. Now I'm going to show you three picks which has a leader in it. You're going to say me one character of him which made him a successful or a non-successful leader. So let's see, the first word which comes to your mind when I show this. So the first leader is this. So what is the one word that you can think of?
Optimistic.
Lip of talking.
Sorry?
Yes,
lip of talking. Communication. Okay. The next one?
Theoretical.
Okay. That's interesting.
Ruthless.
Sorry?
Ruthless.
Okay. So, yeah. Here. Now the second leader is
Andrew. Ruthless again.
All of us know who is he?
Dictator.
Okay. So the word is
dictator.
Any other words?
Angry
man.
Ruthless.
Okay. And the third leader is the very famous one.
Comedian,
okay. That's interesting.
Businessman.
So we have seen all these three leaders. I think you agree with me that all these three are different in their nature. They're different in their leadership styles. So one thing you can observe is, you can be a successful leader only if you possess a combination of all these things. I don't think one can achieve a success with just being authoritative like Hitler or just with the communication skills like a Modi. There will be always some set of people who are against you, or the third one, just being stupid. it doesn't mean that leadership skills, leadership style is just a combination of one thing. It's a combination of multiple skills that you possess. Sometimes you have to be authoritative for the people who don't listen. Sometimes you just have to convey your things via communication who listen to you. And there are some people who don't listen at all or who performs their best way. You have to be nice with them. So there are different skills or different styles of leadership, authoritative or you can just declarative or statement, whatever the leadership style you consider. A successful leader should have a combination of all of things, because you never know what is the circumstances and what is the set of people that you are handling. So hereby I come to the conclusion that when you come to my leadership skills, from these 4 months of my leadership, the one thing that I've learned is you can't. It is not easy to handle people with one skill you have. You have to change your leadership style, that is a dynamic leadership style. You have to keep the dynamic leadership style to handle multiple people. That is something which I learned in this 4 months of leadership, and I continue to pursue that style of leadership where you have to change. You have to talk to people to get sorted out, you have to fight with people to sort it out, or you just have to ignore. There are all the three behaviors that you have to inculcate to become a successful leader. So continuing my journey, I would like to prefer a dynamic leadership styles where you have to literally change the behaviors as per the circumstances and set of the people that you handle. So with that note, I conclude that there is no perfect leader, there is no perfect leadership style. It all depends on how you handle the situation or how you react to the situation. I hope we continue to just be a great leader with whatever the situations that we are exposed to in our day-to-day life. You do not have to be a senior vice president or a CEO to become a leader. Just take up the things that you get in your daily life and become a great successful leader. And that is what Toastmaster teaches us, that where leaders are made. Thank you so much. Over to the Toastmaster.